Well, folks, I'm hoping you can still hear me. I just got cut off from Facebook, but I am continuing. I'm going to give it a couple of seconds here to see if everybody can tune back in. I apologize. Technology, of course, is always going to do its thing, but I am now continuing with the tour. Once everybody has a chance to log back on again, you can always count on technology to mess with you at a time like this. So we are now looking at the garden mount of the Crowfield Plantation, which on the map I showed you earlier was called an Indian mound. So that might have been one of the symbolic ideas. There were a lot of natural Indian mounds that were found in the Lowcountry from tribes like the Santee. One of those can still be found near Santee, South Carolina. But for this one of the accounts says that it was terraced. So when I think about the terraces at Middleton, you can imagine smaller terraces on the side of this Indian mount. And the people would climb to the top, mainly to observe what was going on the far side. And from there, we go all the way down to the end. And for our last vista, as we can imagine, all the formal circles, all sorts of things happening down here as far as the beauty of nature surprises. There's mentions of grottos, cave dwellings. Maybe those were on the sides of those mounds because there are no hills around here, no natural caves. But the surprise of all surprises, when you got to the end and you see a large rectangular pond that bounded the north side of the garden, there was another mount right in the middle of the pond, and on top of that mount was a Roman temple, part of the neoclassical architecture of that day. And one of my former students told me that they drained this pond a couple of years ago when he was working for the golf course crew, and they could see the remnants of a statue on the bottom of the pond. I hope they let me know the next time they're doing that. So you can imagine the reflection in the pond of a Roman temple, and just all whimsical, everything designed for the pleasure of the moment, to enjoy this beautiful environment. So one of these days, maybe you can come and visit Crowfield Plantation. You'll find the directions are not hard. And take a walk through an area that's really, if you walk right through, you wouldn't think too much of it, unless you know what you're looking at. But this is the remains of the oldest formal landscape garden in America, and one that I think deserves a little bit of attention when it comes to the history books. And to imagine, in 1754, William Middleton packed up his bags and left his family, took them to England to go to the original Crowfield Hall, which he had inherited from his great aunt. And from that point on, all of this land just slowly degraded and went back to its natural course. One of the lessons in history is sometimes fame and fortune are fleeting. And today, I think the ruins of Crowfield Plantation stand as a testament to an olden time. Damn it. I need the charger. Where's the charger? Went dead. Why did I not take it with me? So how did it end? What's that?
I don't know. I was picking weeds and I was looking at the comments and everybody was like, what happened?
Oh, is everybody getting dizzy again? I'm afraid I had a little trouble with my battery wearing down on me. I've got backup battery right now. But I hope you were able to get a gist of Crowfield Plantation as I've been humbled by technology. So with that, let me see if I see any. I see a few folks getting a little dizzy here. It's kind of hard walking through poison ivy and keeping that camera steady. But I am back, and if y'all have any questions for me now, oh yeah, I'm live again. Hope you didn't hear me cursing when the battery went dead. It's good to see all these famous people logging on to listen to the commentary. And at this point, I'm going to sign off while this little battery pack is still working, and just ask for y'all to keep watching. Bulldog Tours is going to keep these broadcasts coming at 2 p.m. each day, and you'll see a little bit of culinary history, some really good ghost stories. Sometimes we even have evening broadcasts, so you can have a ghost story at night from one of our local cemeteries, like Magnolia Cemetery. And it's just been a lot of fun, and the folks here at Bulldog Tours have really been enjoying giving these tours. We're all volunteering our time just to kind of reach out a little bit and keep in touch with the community. But I hope y'all keep watching, and I might see if I can come up with some more ideas as well. So you folks, take care, and I'm going to log off for now.